نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث صدق الله العظيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما
اللهم
صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا سيدي يا حبيب الله Respected guests, Hazrat Allama Dr. Professor Abdul Quddus Sahib and Qari Muhammad Shabir Khan Sahib and my dear brothers, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. All praise is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has given us the opportunity to be part of such a gathering where we are praising not only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala but His beloved, our Rasul sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. Today I'm going to talk to you about the coming of the mercy of all creation, the milad of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The verse of the glorious Quran of which I had the honor of the reciting is verse 11 of Surah Duha. Wa amma bi ni'mati rabbika fahaddith. And publicize well the favors of your Lord. Just in this ayat alone, we are being told to celebrate milad. If it's not compulsory, it's wajib. In this verse, we are being ordered to publicize and make apparent the favors bestowed upon us by our Creator. Undoubtedly, the greatest favor on mankind is the sending of Rasul Pak sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As mentioned in Surah Al-Imran, verse 164, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states, لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ بَعَثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا. Allah has indeed bestowed a great favor upon the Muslims in that He sent to them a noble messenger. Even though there are many ways to rejoice, celebrate, publicize the coming of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. For example, getting together in such gatherings, listening to the excellencies and the blessings of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, learning about and acting upon the blessed sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. One of the best ways of celebrating Milad is one which we learn from the following hadith mentioned in Muslim Sharif, volume 1, page 368. It is narrated by Hazrat Abu Qatada Ansari radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who says, Anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam su'ila an sawmi yawm bil isnain, qala zaka yawmun wulidtu fih. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked why he fasted on Mondays. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, this was the day on which I was born. So here, just from this hadith alone, we see that the Prophet ﷺ celebrated his own milad. From the mentioned verses, it has been seen the greatest bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unto all mankind is that the Prophet ﷺ. Therefore, we should rejoice and thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the best manner possible, and the best manner for us to follow is that of Prophet ﷺ. From the hadith, we see Prophet ﷺ would fast on Mondays in commemoration of their birth. Similarly, we should try to fast. I pray to Almighty Allah that gives us all the ability to act upon the teachings of Islam. Amen.
Wa ma alayna ala al-balagh wal-mubin.
SubhanAllah.